Hey, what's up Blender users, I am Jonathan, and in today's video I'll show you how we can use the new volume modifiers in Blender 2.91 to easily create clouds in Eevee. This is especially useful because now we can see our cloud in the viewport and are not limited to node-only setups. This video is pre-recorded and uploaded, so if in the meantime any other creators published a tutorial about the same topic, I'm sorry. And with that said, let's get straight into the video. Oh, and by the way, if you enjoy my content, consider subscribing because I upload a new video every Saturday. To create a cloud with the new volume modifiers, we of course first need a base mesh that represents our cloud. And I'll create this one with metaballs. So let's add in a metaball and maybe scale it down. And now with Shift D, we can just duplicate it and move them into a shape that roughly represents a cloud. We also don't need much detail in the shape, because we'll later use displacement modifiers on our volume to create all the little details in our cloud. So once you have a basic metaball shape, let's select it and press Ctrl A and choose Visual Geometry to Mesh. This will convert our metaballs to a mesh. And now we can use this empty volume object together with the Mesh to Volume modifier to create a volume out of this mesh. And as you can see right here, we also have a volume displace modifier, which we will use to later add all the little details to our cloud. Now, this modifier has some settings, but the most important one is definitely the voxel amount one. We can use this slider to control the resolution of our volume. But for now, I will keep it relatively low, to about 64 voxels, because that way all the volume displace modifiers will all load pretty quick. So, let's start with the first iteration. And let's add in some of the bigger details. So let's click on New and then this button right here and choose Clouds. I will use a scale of maybe about 2. We can also adjust the depth for some finer detail. We can now play around with the strength slider, but be aware that if you slide it too high, Blender could crash. This happened to me in the past. You can also see that the volume is clearly displaced on an axis. This might become apparent later, but right now we will keep the strength pretty low, so this shouldn't be an issue. Great, now that we have some bigger details, we of course want to add more. So let's add them some medium ones. Let's again select clouds, but now maybe a size of 1. And you can already see that we get some finer details around the edge. This is great, and we can now also adjust the strength, maybe even into the negative direction, to get a cloud shape we like. And just like in the normal displace modifier, you can also choose an object to control the texture mapping. And this is already looking good, so let's add even smaller details. You can now see that we have to turn down the strength a lot, to maybe 0.25. Great, and if we now up the voxel amount to maybe 128, we can really see all the detail in our cloud. Okay, that's great, but there are still some things left to do. Let's firstly go into rendered mode, add in a sun lamp right above, and give it a strength of maybe 10. We will use this sunlight to just light up our cloud. To make this more pretty, let's also enable volumetric shadows and let's turn down the tile size to 2 pixels. And we can already see that our cloud is starting to look like a cloud. But clouds often have a flattened bottom, and we can easily do this with just a few nodes. So let's select our volume, click New, and let's add in a gradient texture. For now, I'll set the tile size back to 8 pixels. So everything renders a lot faster. We can now plug the factor into the density slider and with Ctrl T add in a texture coordinate and a mapping node. You can see that nothing is really happening right now, so let's select the object coordinates. And now our gradient is cutting off our cloud in the middle, but this happens on the wrong axis, so let's rotate it 90 degrees on the Y axis. And now we can see that our cloud has a flat bottom. But this falloff is right now pretty harsh. So let's add an AMIX RGB node as well as a noise texture and mix the vector with the factor of the noise. And if we now adjust the slider, you can see that we can make the falloff a bit more interesting. We can now of course adjust the noise size and make it more noticeable with a color ramp. Now all that's left to do is maybe add in a math node, set it to multiply, and now we can make the cloud a lot thicker. Great, let's change our tile size back to 2 and preview our cloud. And this is already looking pretty good. But of course, we are still missing our sky background. So let's add in a camera, clear out everything, and rotate it 90 degrees on the x-axis. and now we can just move it back and have it face our cloud. And now let's add in our world background. The easiest way to do this is to add in another gradient texture, and you can see that again it is on the wrong axis. So let's rotate it 90 degrees on the y-axis, change it to easing to have a smoother gradient, and let's add in a color ramp and now make the one handle a light blue color and the other one a dark blue color. But you can see that we are only seeing the light blue one, and this is because all the dark is left on the top. But we can easily change this by adjusting the X location, and now we have our nice gradient in the background. Awesome! And now we have a very simple cloud in Blender. And we can even just use this mesh, scale it maybe up or down, to easily create variations of our cloud. For example, just like this. In the end, I would suggest you to turn up the samples right here to maybe 128. And also turn up the voxel amount. Keep in mind, this voxel amount is relative to what you did in your scene. Okay, great, and that's basically it. This is how we can now easily create custom clouds and volumes in Blender Eevee. Right now, I would only suggest you to use this in Eevee, because in Cycles, some interesting visual bugs can occur, like blockiness in your volume. I hope this tutorial was helpful, I hope you learned something, and if you did, consider liking and subscribing, and we'll see you in the next video, next Saturday.